it's your ground. Oh my god, this is very cool. Even you can see a lot of cosplay in here from anyone.
I'm a little bit of a fan. So, there are living proof that if you're doing what you love, you're not really working. Welcome to the stage, Hilly and Hannah. Now, the Hollywood Show!
You got a shirt on location in London. Like, how do you source those things to get access to that really niche stuff?
We tried really hard. I don't know. We always call it a God thing because it just becomes too complicated. Like, how we got the cast of Supernatural was because we met Ozzy 2 years ago at a Spain convention that we didn't even like know each other, and then that developed into Walking Dead parody with him, and then it developed into him talking to Richard to talk to a cast. And then like with 221B, they knew us because of our Doctor Who parody, because if we hadn't done Doctor Who parody, they never let anyone in.
She just told you to go.
Like, it's just where you back up and you're like, it's too big of a picture, this is a bad story, and I take no credit because I don't know how it happens, honestly, so.
Please join me in welcoming to the stage an icon of the entertainment industry, Mr. Christopher Lloyd!
There we go. Good morning. And thank you all for coming out. What a reception.
Thank you for coming.
Oh, my delight. Last time I was here in Auckland and New Zealand was somewhere in the early 1990s, late 1980s. Just a bunch of Auckland birds.
Auckland, please put your hands together. Welcome to the stage, Nichelle Nichols. Firstly, welcome to New Zealand. Oh, sorry.
I'm a bit nervous.
So we're going to ask a few questions. I'll play some clips of the scenes and feel free to tell any story you like. We're really here to hear what you have to say. We'll throw it out to the audience in a minute.
This is not true or false. My answers will be true. As true as I know.
So the first thing I'd like to ask is, there's a story about when you meet Dr. Martin Luther King. I understand that someone said that one of your greatest fans was there. One of your greatest fans was there to meet you. And when you turned around, it was Dr. King. What was that like?
It was incredible because all my family were followers of Dr. King, not everyone that I knew. He was such a great man. And when I finally met him, I didn't even know I was going to meet him. And so, you know, when you get in a situation like that, and you say, I'm really glad to meet you. And then he said, I'm so happy to meet you too. I'm a big fan of the show. And I said, thank you, Doctor.
That brings us to our next guests. Let's be honest, they made us laugh at their variety of pranks and jokes. They made us solemnly swear that we were up to no good. And I'm pretty sure they all made us feel something with their bravery and sacrifice in the last battle. Auckland, put your hands together, give a warm New Zealand welcome to Homer and James Phelps, also known as
This isn't as good as it gets, so yeah. Feel free to make noise, be happy, be fun, enjoy your bank holiday weekend. And let's get started.
Alright.
That's gonna get away with not saying anything. My favourite spell would be what I would use in real life.
Yeah.
We like a load of more and some boys going to draw the next hour. Mine isn't actually a spell, if I can cheat, it's something from the world which would be a port key. Because I was travelling for about 26 hours to get here. And that sucked. So if you could just touch something and then you'd be there right away, I think that would be my one. In terms of films to watch or to film?
I guess both.
Okay, but to make, the Goblet of Fire is probably my favourite one to make because we had just the best time. It was a slightly longer filming process anyway, so we were filming a lot more, got our hair down, we were out doing God knows what elsewhere, and it was brilliant, so much fun, like learning how to dance for the Yule Ball scene, filming on all these different locations and stuff, so, and the camaraderie on the set was just so memorable. I mean, all of them are very memorable in their own way, but that's the first one I always think of when I think of Harry Potter as a fourth film. Mine would be the first movie probably to make, because everything was new. I was learning all the time on what everyone, but how many people were there, or just everything. It was so over-inspiring. But probably my favourite could be the third movie, probably, The Prisoner of Azkaban. I really enjoyed that one.
Find out where these guys are, when they're doing it, and of course they'll be back here on the main stage at 1 o'clock on Monday. Tonight they will be cheering on the All Blacks, so Auckland, join me in thanking the Australian appreciation once again for James Carter.